how's that? Hey, come look at this. Let's go look. A real meteorite. It's red hot.
What?
I gotta get a picture of this. Hey, don't forget the flash attachment. Hey! Where is it? I can't find anything. Hey! Can you hear me?
Oh, you can't be
serious? It's miserable out.
So it's a little wet.
Oh.
If you don't get up right away.
I know.
Hot water's on the blink again. Might as well get out and take care of it now.
I don't suppose this changes our plans.
Oh, definitely. We'll be about 2 or 3 minutes late. Get up. Thank you.
Sam. Sam?
It's
Frankie. Yeah, I know. I kept waking up. It was so loud. Oh, that was my aunt. My aunt and uncle here visiting. What? What are you getting so worried about? Look, biology isn't exactly my strong point either. What about tonight? I could still go. No, I said my folks have a car today, not tonight. What about your car? Oh. Well, look, if you were to get here about 6 or 6:30, as soon as my folks got back, we could leave right away. So walk on over later on this morning. Yeah, we could study. It's a perfect day for it. So wear your galoshes and a big raincoat. Oh, and don't forget those skimpy notes of yours if you can locate them. And, maybe Ellen can come along, too. Oh, yeah, why not? I thought you said she was good at this. So call and find out. Right down. Look, Frankie, I told you to forget about that garbage. Look, if you're going to study for a science exam with me, you've got to stick to the facts. Frankie, Falakovsky doesn't know what he's talking about. Look, if house flies originated on Jupiter, then how come they have the same exact enzymes and nucleic acids as all living things on Earth? I did read it. Well, most of it. No. Throw it away. Burn it. Then call it science fiction because that's what it is. Look, when you come over later on, I'll loan you Broca's brain. It's a book.
What are you doing? Herb, there's nothing wrong with that kid. I like him.
Rose.
Charles is a normal 10-year-old boy. Keeps to himself, he's quiet, except in the mornings. I think he's a great kid. So he's a movie fan. Big deal. He's very imaginative. Just tell her he's okay.
If there's no problem, I will. I don't mind doing this.
Well, it's my vacation, too. How many eggs?
What kind?
Hens.
Scrambled?
Be wearing it to breakfast. If you do, be careful you don't trip coming down the stairs.
Oh, we can't go back down that way. That tunnel, it's loaded with those things. We have to find another way. Come on, we've got to get them out of there.
But how?
Through the ventilator shaft in the north wing.
Oh, Bob, don't touch it!
Water south of Long Island, 40 degrees north.
Oh, good morning. What, did Mom and Dad leave already?
Crack of dawn, I gather. They were talking yesterday how they wanted to get an early start.
Yeah. Did they say anything about tonight? I'm supposed to get the car.
No, I don't think so. They left before we got up.
They're going to give us a call later. Oh, by the way, who was that on the telephone, Pete?
That was a friend of mine. Right. He and Ellen are coming over later.
Ellen?
Oh, they're sort of going together.
Well, well. Good morning. Your aunt tells me you have a wild costume.
Yeah.
A wild costume?
A leopard.
A what?
A leopard. Do you have a girlfriend, Pete?
What?
A girlfriend?
No, not really.
Oh, your mom said something about a cute blonde.
Well, that was Kathy. Mom tends to exaggerate.
Well,
want some jelly, Charles. It's okay. I'll get it.
So how long is your vacation?
Don't worry. We'll be out of your hair by Monday. I'm only kidding. I have to be at a conference in Bridgeton on the 2nd.
Hold on. Is it some sort of psychologist meeting?
Exactly.
Which reminds me, you men are going to have to fend for yourself for lunch. I have to go over to Mother's to help her with her party.
Today? In this rain?
Oh, your grandmother doesn't cancel a vegetarian luncheon on account of bad weather. Anyway, you have your choice between tuna salad and hamburgers. I envy you.
I'll take care of everything. And I'm looking forward to having a talk with Charlie today.
He prefers to be called Charles.
Sorry, is that right?
Doesn't matter.
Have a talk about what?
This and that.
You're going into analysis? About time.
What do you mean?
I have normal conversations too, Pete. You're pretty quick. Sam tells me you're a scientist?
Science major.
It's the same thing, if you have a scientific method.
Well, I suppose you're right about that. Well, just say I'm studying.
Oh, you're just being modest. You're an astrologer, aren't you?
Astronomer? Pete's not interested in the lunatic fringe, I'm sure.
Do you remember how the thing from another world got killed?
Speaking of the lunatic fringe, why don't you mess around with that junk?
It's not junk.
The what from what?
The thing from another world.
Famous monsters.
Come on, how did
that
it get killed?
You
oh, sure, I know.
No, I saw it. I just remember the ending.
You saw it a long time ago. He was just a kid. How are you getting to Grandma's?
Walking. Or swimming, it looks like.
You guys don't mind doing the dishes, do you? I've got to go. Now, where's she coming?
That cat is crazy.
We will bring you the new details on this story as they become available throughout the day.
What is it with the basement this morning?
It's a cold.
I hope it does let up. I promised Frank and Ellen I'd drive us to the movies tonight.
It's going to be wet and chilly, so stay indoors if you can. It looks like it's going to be a bad day.
Sit down, Charles. Would you be willing to help me with some things for my conference next week?
Sure.
Great. There's going to be a discussion group of behaviorists in child psych, and I think your hobby would be very interesting. I mean, you're so into it. Do you mind?
No.
Great. So I can ask you some questions? You don't have to answer if you don't want to. Let's see now. First of all, do you have any favorite monsters?
Yeah, I guess so.
What are they?
The mole people, Frankenstein. It, the terror from beyond space.
Uh-huh. Now, this one is tricky. How real are they to you?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, are you ever afraid that you might run into one in real life? Oh, I don't mean afraid, but I mean, do you ever think you might see one, like a... You might see an alligator or a bear? Or...
No. Maybe Bigfoot or something.
Ah, okay. Does it ever bother you that they're not real?
No, that's why I like them.
Uh-huh, good answer. Do you like scaring people?
Yeah, it's fun.
Do you ever get scared yourself?
I mean, really scared?
Yes, uh-huh.
Not really. Maybe sometimes. I used to.
Do you have nightmares?
Yeah, I guess so.
What about?
I don't know. People chasing me, but I can't run fast enough. Stuff like that.
People chasing you, not monsters?
No.
Are you afraid of the dark?
Not really.
Would you be willing to put on one of your monster costumes and scare me?
Well,
That's stupid. How could you scare me if I know about it? Besides, I don't scare easily. Forget about it. I tell you what, though, I'm going to be working down here for a while. How about if I come up later and you show me some of your stuff? How would that be, okay?
Okay.
Great. End of session. Thank you, Charles.
Thank you. Well, that's why the electrician's coming.
Well, he was supposed to, but I doubt very much if he'll come.
Anyways, I was standing there, and she was looking at this...
this thing.
We have a little surprise for you.
What?
I don't know whether to lead up to it first, or just show it to her.
You're not going to believe this.
What?
Where's your bathroom?
Upstairs.
What?
I better dump it in the sink.
What? What are you guys talking about? Dump what in the sink?
I really don't know.
Frank! Hey, Frankie!
Here's where we find out how smart he is, Frank.
Is that alive?
No.
What the hell is it?
I told Ellen maybe it washed up out of the creek or something, you know, after all that rain and all.
I can't even tell if it's a vertebrate.
Oh, it's crazy. It's like a freak of nature.
If it is a vertebrate, these bumps suggest the order of Apodes, Apodes, however you say it. But I've never seen anything like it.
Maybe it's an eel.
You mean those bumps might be, undeveloped feet?
Yes, some form of locomotion.
Was it dead when you found it?
Yeah.
Slimy.
That's why I put it in the sink. Look at the teeth.
Holy mackerel.
Hardly. I wouldn't say there's anything holy about it. It's more like a nasty tadpole.
That's funny. Like the mackerel? Get it? Like the fish?
Yeah, we got it.
So what is it? A dead fish? A worm? What?
A worm? You mean a sort of mutant Adelita? Yeah, but it's too big for that. With those teeth, it could almost be a fish. Or it could be a misshapen lamprey, like Frankie suggested.
Lamprey?
Yeah, that's what you said.
No.
Yes, lamprey. It's like an eel.
Oh.
But no gills. Nothing except these weird little bumps.
Well, what about a big earthworm? Which is what Annalita means. Oh. Is that on the test? Yeah.
Seriously, what do you think, Pete?
I'm thinking I don't believe my eyes.
I told you you wouldn't believe it.
It's not possible. There simply is no such thing.
But here it is. It reminds me of coelacanth.
Ooh, what?
Yeah, coelacanth.
Coelacanth.
It's a prehistoric fish they thought was extinct till some fisherman hauled one up back in
1930s. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, but you know what you're saying? That this thing has had to reappear from the fathomless depths of where? The creek.
So what's your hypothesis?
I'm going to fail the test, I know.
What if it's not full grown yet? What if your tadpole joke isn't too far from the truth? This could be the spawn of a freshwater eel.
Maybe I was right.
Hmm. I'm going to look it up.
Okay. I got a better idea. Huh? I'm going to dissect it.
Ellen!
Look, Ellen!
Hey, look, if it's not in our book, my father's got a key upstairs somewhere, all right?
Hey, everybody, what about the biology test?
Frank, ask Pete if he's got some straight pins.
Pete!
Yeah. Pete? Does your mother have an old cookie sheet or something?
Yeah. Frankie.
Yeah?
Go down in the kitchen, look under the sink, all right?
Thank you. Green sauce. These are the green sauce.
Shall I peel them?
Don't you dare. Now just wash them and scrub them a little and line them up on the counter.
Sure is inclement.
That won't stop the girl.
Huh?
something funny going on.
Oops.
I must be going crazy. That's new?
Why, what's the matter?
I think I'm seeing things.
That's new.
Pete, let him answer. What did you see?
Well, this sounds dumb, but I could have sworn I saw that eel thing lying at the top of the stairs just before I went in the bathroom. When I came back out, there wasn't anything there.
You mean just now?
Yeah, remember I said, what are you doing? Then I saw it was in the stone sink, and, well, I couldn't figure it out. There's nothing there now.
Oh, boy, do you have an old rack of imagination.
Do you think some more of those things somehow got in the house?
I mean, right now while I was dissecting it?
I know I wasn't imagining it.
Pete, this is getting creepy. This whole thing is making me nervous. I think we should tell somebody.
Frankie, starts seeing things. You get a creepy feeling. It's a little monster from outer space in the bathroom. Oh, brother.
I didn't say anything about little monsters.
What's the matter with you all of a sudden? You're both acting like kids. Look, Frankie's been filling his head with science fiction for years, but I'm surprised at you.
You always know everything. Why couldn't something come from outer space anyway?
Because it's impossible, that's why. Scientifically impossible. What happened to the scientific method? Look, I say we calmly go through the books we have and solve this thing scientifically.
Stop being so pompous. You're acting like a teacher. I can be just as scientific as you. And it is too scientific and logical when you see a crazy, mixed-up system of internal organs to start imagining, maybe...
A scientist does not use his imagination. He deals in facts.
That's ridiculous. You have to use your imagination to suppose anything at all. Without supposition, there's nothing to prove.
Did you see that thing in the sink climb out of a flying saucer?
Oh, you still don't understand what I'm
saying.
How
do you know? When you see a thing, you say, I've seen that before. They exist. You see it crash with your own eyes. It smashes into a million pieces. Go downstairs, out the door, to look at it with a microscope. But maybe some cedar or something grew out of it and grew up into an alien creature. Now, you didn't see that part, but it happened. Then there's this whole invasion, and you just go right out thinking everything's fine and dandy.
I give up on you. I give up on you, Valakovsky, and the houseflies from Jupiter. Look, all I know is a creepy feeling is not scientific.
I vote we show it to your uncle and ask him what he thinks.
Monsters from outer space are pure ignorance. Look, we still have a lot of books to go through here. Okay? Frankie, if you go upstairs in the attic, on the left-hand side is a cardboard box inside the door. My father's college biology book is
Pete,
in there, okay?
I'm the one who just dissected it, and the inside don't make any sense.
Everything makes sense sooner or later. We just don't have enough data. I hope his science fiction brain isn't getting to you. You're a lot smarter than he is.
Maybe, in some ways. So what? Brains aren't everything.
Well, yeah, I know. One thing bothers me about you.
What?
Well, you seem like two different people to me.
Go on.
One's straight A's. Real smart.
And the other one?
Well, the other one is a girl who comes into my room and sits down next to me on my bed.
Who sat next to who?
Are you and Frankie going together or not?
Well, we're going to the movies with you tonight.
You know what I mean. Are you going together? I guess you know Frankie would rather go to the movies with somebody else.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, you know Kathy Todd?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, he'd rather take her anywhere than go with us. So you're not going with him?
No.
You want to go with me?
To the movies? Pete, I think I have to figure out a few things about you first. I know the real reason you want to go with me to the movies, and it's not to see the movie. Because if you went to see the movie, you'd probably faint trying not to use your imagination.
never seen this giraffe before.
He's new.
He's big.
Don't you just love him?
To pieces.
Do you know what I've always wanted?
What?
A really handsome gorilla.
A what?
A gorilla. But they don't seem to make fine ceramics of the great apes for some reason. They are our nearest relation, you know, the great apes. But they never left the proverbial Garden of Eden like we did.
Did you know he's a vegetarian?
Who is?
The gorilla. No eating
of
flesh for him, no, sir.
He's peace-loving and adorable.
Good Lord. Mother, you're crazy.
Too much, but you can freeze them, you know.
Can I put this on the wall?
I'll get it.
Oh. What is it? Ratatouille.
I'll leave the stew on the stove.
And move these
Bunny, not your lentil and tomato stew.
Yes, with brown rice and green sauce.
I'm just fine, and you have to change. Always
the same. This is not to be believed, really. Out of this world. This is a giraffe. Elsie, she's famous for it.
I mean a giraffe.
Oh, good. Oh, no. And do you like it?
Love it very much.
Mm. Well,
you've done it again.
Why don't you girls sit down? I'm just going to finish the green sauce.
Did something new this time.
Hello, operator. I've been trying to get through to my husband, and either it doesn't ring at all, or I get this funny beeping sound.
Oh, do dip into it.
Of course.
Fairview 90326. Oh, I see. Oh, dear. Mm-hmm. I guess I'll keep on trying then. Thank you.
Ha ha ha!
superb. Look at this. Did you hear Charles's voice?
What are we going to do? We got to get out of here.
Hold it, wait a minute.
We can't just walk out of here. This thing's all over the place. It doesn't make any sound. It sort of just slides along. I wish I knew where Charles was.
Why aren't you?
Shh. I thought I heard something. Stay here.
Oh, no. No way. I'm coming with you.
You're not going to leave us here.
Look, we don't know if it's still out there. Now, shut up.
When I say now, everybody run to my room. Okay? Now, come over here. All right, ready? Thank you.
Frankie. Frankie, we gotta get out of here. How about the roof? Can we get to the roof from here? Please, Frankie, we have to do something. I can't stand it.
I don't know. Maybe they got away. At least it's Pete's bedroom.
No, I didn't hear her scream. Something terrible happened.
They must have gotten to Pete's bedroom. Look!
What are those things? Frankie, what the hell are they? What's going on?
I don't know. But those things are everywhere. Ellen dissected one of those things.
Dissected for
them. You should have seen what they did to Pete's uncle. Still sitting there, which is pretty funny when you think about it. You can't get the keys anyway. What difference does it make?
What are you talking about?
Come on, we're gonna go downstairs.
Pete, where are you going?
Downstairs, come on.
No, no, you can't. It'll get you. You'll let it in.
I'm pretty scared.
Thank you. get around the house. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
I don't think he's hurt badly, but
this way.
He seems to be in a state of shock.
Okay. Let's get her in front.
K24, come in.
Roger, Bob. How's it going?
Well, we're through here for tonight. How's it where you are?
Under control. They just pulled a 3-foot thing out of the bushes.
3 foot, that's nothing. You see what they got down out of the attic. 8 feet long.
8 feet?
I guess they just keep growing.
8 feet? What do you say to write a book when this is all over?
Yeah, I'll be right over. K24, come in, K24, get...